Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. Today I'm going to show you how to make a custom textbox that has watermark. First of all, open Visual Studio. Add new project. Select Visual C Sharp. And here Windows Form application. Select any .NET framework. I'm selecting just 4.5. And give name to your project, any name that you like to give to it, and then click the OK button or simply click the enter button. Add another project to the solution. For this purpose, right click on solution, choose new project from add, or simply go to file menu and here add submenu, and then click new project. This time select classic desktop. Scroll down and search for Windows Form Control Library. Click it. That will create a dynamic library DLL file which can be used later on also in any other project by importing that DLL file. Give any name to the project. One thing should be noted that you can add as many control as you want to add to this desktop project. So my suggestion is that do not give any name that just only pointing out to that control you are just focusing, such as text box. Anyhow, just give any name and click OK to create this project. Now we will create and design the control. In our case, that is text box. Go to the code view and here change form to text box in order to inherit it from text box. Now from build menu, click build solution. It will take some time while building the solution and give an error at the end. Simply double click the error that you received, and this time just remove this code offline. Rename user control 1 to name you want your text box to be named and referenced for future use. I rename it as the Khan Watermark Textbox and double click it to open. The actual programming starts now. First of all, declare variables. I'm going to declare two variables, one for watermark text and another for disabling and hiding multi-line option from the properties. Private string underscore watermark, private bool underscore multi-line equal to false. By default, I am giving false value to underscore multi-line because I don't like textbox to be multi-lined. We want that developer has a custom property in properties windows so that he or she can write any watermark in property. In order to show custom properties in property window, we will make a public property with that name, such as watermark. In our case, that is watermark, so we will create watermark text. Hence we declared underscore watermark as a string. We will create the properties also a string, otherwise that won't work. Public string watermark text. One thing should be noted that do not write parentheses after property's name. Start braces, hit enter. Next we need to get and set property value. In order to get, type get open braces, return underscore watermark. Oh, sorry, I have forgotten to type the return. After that, we will need to assign watermark text to the private declared variable, that is underscore watermark. To do so, we will write set underscore watermark equal to value. Another stage is to show that watermark in text box as watermark. For this purpose, we will call a function which we will create shortly. I have named that as get set watermark. Hence, we have not yet created this function. It will give an error. Just right click that function and generate method. It will create a function for you below the codes. We will write this function later on. As I don't like this text box to be multi-lined, if you also do not like the text box to be multi-lined, do set and get value as I do. Otherwise, skip this. Besides disabling multi-line option, I also do not like to show multi-line property in properties window. We have declared, and so as multi-line property is either true or false property. Hence, our custom property watermark text box inherited from traditional text box, it will contain all the properties of text box, and those we want to add. Simply, if we do not like a property to be shown, we will hide that property, as we are going to hide multi-line property. To override property, we will use public new bool multi-line, open braces. Keep in mind that name of the property must be exactly same as already defined, otherwise it won't work. As I have already told that I do not like the property to be shown in the properties window, I will write one line of code to hide that property. Open square bracket, browsable, open parenthesis, false. This code of line will hide the property. Now to get and set the property, get open braces, return underscore multi-line, set open braces underscore multi-line equal to false semicolon. This line of code will disable the multi-lining from the task menu of the text box. To get and set the watermark in text box, in this point we will write code in get set watermark function that we have generated. Select this line and simply delete it. We want if text box has text which is same as watermark, or our text box is empty, then text box should have watermark text, and that text must be in gray color. If text box is not empty and also not equal to watermark text, then its color must be black. To do so, we will write a couple lines of code. Write if fresh step twice, so that Visual Studio complete if block for you. This dot text equal to watermark text. Or this dot text equal to string dot empty. Hit enter. This dot for color equal to color dot gray semicolon. This dot text equal to watermark text. Else again press tab twice from the keyboard. This dot for color equal to color dot black. Next step is when the watermarks is to be shown in the text box and when it is to be not shown in text box. It totally depends on you. how and when you want to hide and show the text box watermark. Go to the text box design mode. In properties window, click events, scroll down or up and find it. Totally up to you whether you choose key press, key down, key up, enter or any other method. I double click on enter because I want the code to be written on enter. If text box has text which is equal to watermark, our text box is empty. I want its text color to be black, and if that is watermark, it should not be visible. If press tap twice, this dot text equal watermark text, or this dot text equal string dot empty. Enter. This dot text equal to string dot empty. This dot color equal to black. Last step of coding is when text box loses focus. The text box must be checked. If it has some text and that text is not equal to watermark text, then do nothing. Just leave that. But if the text box is either empty or its text is just equal to watermark's text, then watermark must be shown and color must be changed to gray color. Once again, go to design mode, and this time I will double click leave, because on leave I will code that, and simply copy this function, paste it, semicolon, save the project, build solution. It will take some time to build it. Solution built successfully. See, the traditional text box has not watermark text property. In order to use this newly created text box, go to toolbox window, and here you will find that text box. Just drag and drop that text box. Here you can find watermark text. Just type anything that you want to be shown as watermark. That multi-line option is not working anymore. Neither you will find it here. But the traditional text box that will have the multi-line option and can be multi-lined. I hope you would have liked this video. Please subscribe to our channel, like and share this video. Thanks for watching.